Hi everyone, how are you all doing today? And like promised, we're here and I'm going to be inviting my very, very good friend and one of the greatest Indian women cricketer onto this live show today. I'm very, very excited because she's also my college friend. Grew up together, like I say, and I'm going to invite her very soon. So stay put. Connect her right away. So how are you all doing otherwise? Just wait for her. Oh yes, here she is.
Hi.
Hi, Tanish. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Great, Machan. Great. Is the connection okay?
Yeah. It seems fine. I'm just trying to set it right.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Lovely. So, hope everybody back home is safe.
Yeah, things are getting better. I mean, you know, the Chennai situation is a little bad, but it's just getting better. I mean, with Yokos, I think we'll be back on track.
Lovely. Are you working out, keeping yourself fit?
Yeah, the thing is, like, we have to follow. I mean, when you're so used to working out outdoor, no? So, keeping indoor is something, it's very different. But yeah, I'm trying to get the hang of it. I mean, by now, yeah, things are settled down and I just got a bit of how to do everything.
Super. I'm just going to tell my viewers here a little bit about you. Guys, this is Tirush Kamini, one of the finest cricketers in the Indian women's cricket arena. And she was part of the national Indian women's cricket team. And you've played around what that 39 ODIs, like I said.
Yeah, I've right? played 39 ODIs. Yes, I've started playing for India from 2006.
So 2006 my was journey your first started. ODI, right?
Yeah, when I was 16 years, I made my debut for the country at 16 years.
Lovely. Yeah, and guys, Tirush Kamini has won. I think she's the first Indian woman to have won the BCCI Player of the Year prize.
Yeah, I won the BCCI award thrice and I'm the first Indian women cricketer to score a century in the World Cup. That's the record that
Yay!
I created.
Yes, I was coming to that.
Yeah.
The first Indian woman cricketer to have scored a century in the Women's World Cup.
Yes.
Which is phenomenal, Tirush. I mean, what a journey you've had so far.
Yes.
Tell us about it. What, first of all, what inspired you to become...
I mean, it all started I was really passionate about watching the game. And, I mean, unlike others, it's never like I started playing the street cricket and then I got interested. Appadi nadakkuva. It's just that I loved watching the sport. And my dad felt like, okay, this girl is really interested in watching the sport. Why not give it a try? So that's how, you know, my dad inspired me to pick up the bat and go to the ground and give it a shot. And that's how it all started.
As in, you didn't play like gully cricket or anything?
No, nothing of that sort happened. I've never played gully cricket. Suddenly someone comes and asks, Amma, I've never played gully cricket. It's always been professional cricket. Like the first day when I started to play, my dad wanted me to be a professional cricketer. So I've never played the game for fun.
Wow, okay.
Okay.
So
okay, let's talk about you. Tell me, you have to tell me about what inspired you.
No, I've always been interested. I mean, all of us are movie buffs. That is a given. To tell stories through you is something that really kind of intrigued me. I wanted to be a medium where I can tell stories to people through me. So I started doing a lot of theater in college. Slowly, that area I got a little lucky because I got a call very, very early on in my career when I was doing a lot of ad shoots. I don't know if you remember, in college I was doing a lot of ad shoots and I got a call from Sugadas's office asking me to audition for a role. There on, I think the kind of call started rolling. Even today, if I'm not in front of the camera for more than a week, I get really jittery, I get really restless. I think in both our careers, in a way, it's kind of that passion that keeps us going. It's never been like a true. Done moment. Have you felt like no?
The thing is, I'll tell you something very interesting. I am not an early riser, okay? I hate waking up early. But something, you know, when I know I have to go for my practice, you know, that really keeps me going. So that is something I really understood, that the passion that I have for the game, no? Really makes me do something which I generally don't like doing. For starters, I mean, I don't like waking up early.
But when you started, like, how was your practice sessions like?
Generally what happens is either I do my skill sessions in the morning and then I do my fitness regime in the evening depending upon the availability, but it always happens to be like one half will be more of my cardio sessions that I do, or it will be my gym sessions, or it will be some recovery sessions that I do. Apart from that, then in between I'll have a break, or sometimes what happens is we have in between I do my bit of my fielding sessions as well, like in the mid or around 11 o'clock 12 o'clock type. Then post that evening, it has always been my skill. Like, I do a lot of my batting drills, and then I do my batting practice that I do in the evening. So pretty much this is how it goes.
Okay. So how did you manage to come to college?
I mean, in that way,
I mean, I barely saw you in college. You were always like out on the field, like playing.
Remember when? Remember there was time when we had to create a newspaper and all. I'll be like, the newspaper, I have to create pandraze of it to people, you know.
True. Yeah. But I think you were so committed to the field that some things have to take a back seat at some point.
But one good thing is, like, my parents had always inculcated this thought in my mind that academic always has to go side and hand in hand. When you play, even if you're gonna go play a sport, I mean, your academics also has to be there. So that is one good thing, because I mean, for whoever I've become, I didn't lose out on my academics. So I think that is one thing I owe to my parents. And obviously my teachers, because they really did support me at that point.
Lovely. And did you face a lot of negativity in Solamriyadu? Like, a lot of people would have said, like, you need a career in cricket, is it safe and all that, they would have thought back then, 10 years, 15 years back.
To be very honest, there were a lot of people who were very cynical about this whole thing, you know, because Tamil Nadu being a very conservative state as such, let alone cricket, I mean, any sport for that matter, you know, I mean, a girl to pick up a sport at a young age and then go practice and all, it was very difficult. Like, to be very honest with you, like, when I started playing, I couldn't find myself an academy to go, enroll myself and start playing. So that was very difficult for me, because I come from though lucky that I come from a city like Chennai, but I think it really did have to take my parents' support and people around me to really get this whole thing going, because you need the infrastructure as an athlete to practice. So that was really lacking for me, because it was a very male dominant sport as such.
Correct.
So I really didn't have that infrastructure to really pick up my game or take it to the next level.
And so who was your main pillar of support apart from your parents?
The thing is, how my journey went about is, like, every phase, like, I had different people who mentored me. It was like, at initial stage, I've gone to most of the academies in Chennai. Like, I've practiced in most of the academies. Morning, I'll go to one academy. Evening, I'll go to a different academy. So I really can't just pick a particular person and say, this is the person who always helped me or mentored me in Solradhu Kanjikasto. So it has always been, I like to have a lot of opinions or perspectives, because I'm more like a loner, like I like to think about my game as such, but I really like to take opinions and perspectives from people. So on the vagela, on the coaches as such generally have helped me a lot. But it has always been like I try to make my own decisions or which will suit me, abdinradha vandu, I prefer to do it on my own.
Okay, and from what I know, you are both the batsman and you are good in all rounds.
Yes, I'm an excellent, but I would like
hours of hard work.
Yeah, it does because but what happened is I love batting as such. So batting itself is an art that you nearly need to master a lot, because me being an opening batsman, that requires a different type of different hours of practice that I have to dedicate to make myself a very immaculate batsman. So apart from that, I also do my my bowling takes a backseat when I have to say if I'm an all-rounder. Bowling definitely does take a backseat. I mean, if I do about say 5 days of practice of my batting, then I do 1 day of practice for my bowling.
Oh, okay. And
so I mean, it's like more like I'm a batsman who can bowl.
Oh, Anamari. And how do you sustain these injuries as such? Like, how did you get through that?
Injuries patana, like every time, no, whenever you're injured, no, you really have to take a back seat, or in a sort of, you miss out on something, like on your practice sessions matunla. Like imagine I get injured during a season or a tournament, you know, I will have to take a break completely from that from the session as such, or you will be removed out of the tournament. So adhula enna aguna, you have to ensure that you work on a lot of your rehab and get your strength back, and then get to your normal functioning. And because when I talk about cricket, there is something called like you have to be functionally fit.
Correct.
So adhanaala vandu we do a lot of functional training to ensure that my muscles or whichever or however I'm injured, that I'm capable enough not only to do my practices but also to be match fit. So that journey is always been supported by a lot of physios or trainers who are around me. And the moment and the point la vandu, that really does keep you going, because they are the people who really guide you to tell you like how long does it really take for you to step onto the field again, back again. Or in a sort of, the trainer is the one who really executes the whole thing, like the load the load will be monitored, or your recovery is monitored so that you're able to recover faster and get back to the field as soon as possible.
But does it differ from men and women? Like does it take a longer time for you to recover than like?
No, it depends upon individual. It honestly depends upon individual. See, some people have a different strength than others. Some people have a lot of upper body strength. Some might have a lot of lower body strength. Or someone's strength one will be their mobility, stability. It could be different aspect. So it definitely depends upon individuals, like how quickly they're able to recover and they're able to adapt, and their muscles and sort of they're able to recover and repair as well. So it depends upon every individual.
Oh, lovely, lovely. So you didn't consider any other sport, is it, when you came into the? I know you were interested in sports as such, but in the sports you.
No, I loved one. The I liked tennis actually. எனக்கு tennis ரொம்ப பிடிக்கும். Even now, during this, whenever I'm in my off season, I really love to play tennis. I mean, I'm starting to learn because I really like the sport as such. Because that is the only sport in and out where you have an multiple opportunities. You can play singles, you can play doubles, and then you have the mixed doubles. There are too many opportunities where you can just keep playing the sport. I hope that starts coming into cricket as well. Other sport I really love is tennis.
Tennis, is it?
So yeah.
Nice.
Mm. So unakku you've never liked any sport, though? I mean, you've never tried any sport as such.
Very frankly, the only sport I played was table tennis. It was summa jolly and we're playing in school life. I did like tennis court, table tennis court for but I have also been a huge fan of tennis. I'm like a very hard older fan of tennis.
Who's your women la, who do you like?
I have watched undoubtedly I'm
Serena
sisters only undoubtedly. But
They've always been a huge inspiration, la. Serena Williams.
Don't do is a Federer Nadal match or a Federer Djokovic match and all that. Really be hooked on. I think it's a great game, and என் லைஃப்லயே எனக்கு வந்து இப்ப ஹேவ் ஒன் டிஸ்டிங் ஒரு ஒரு டிசைர் அப்படின்னா ஒன் கோ வாட்ச் அ விம்பிள்டன் மேட்ச். இட்ஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் பீன் ஆன் மை ப்ரையாரிட்டி. பட் த வெரி லைக் இன் மை ஹவுஸ் ஆல்சோ அ லாட் ஆஃப் ஸ்போர்ட்ஸ் லவ்ஸ் டு ப்ளே பேட்மிண்டன். ஹி கோஸ் இவன் டுடே இஸ் லைக் 68 நவ. ஹி கோஸ் எவ்ரி டே அண்ட் ஹி கோச்சஸ் அண்ட் ஹி ப்ளேஸ் பேட்மிண்டன் ஃபார் 3 ஆர் 4 ஹவர்ஸ். all obviously in every household in India, we know we're all snowflakes. And I remember one day you had come home and my uncle was so excited to see you. Even after you went back, he was telling everybody that he met you. He's a very diehard Indian fan in the house. This very, very inspiring journey that you had. Tell me about, if I'm not wrong, I think in 2006, you were the captain when, in 2006?
Yeah. I was a captain of the state team.
Okay. How different is it when you are like when you're playing just as another player and when you have to play being the captain of the team?
See, what happens is when you become a captain of the team, no, you are responsible for the most of the things that happens. Like you are the one that you have to decide and you have to back your decision. Like there comes a point where you have to be. Sometimes you have to take brutal decisions too, and you have to stand by it if it doesn't go right.
Yeah.
So, and you have to stand as an example. Like imagine if I go in the way I would, look at a game as an ordinary player is probably I will just look at just winning the game. But when I go into, if I'm a captain and just get into a game, it will be more like I will look at winning the tournament and how well this game will help me winning the tournament and roar factor epome irukum. So that really plays in your mind. You start thinking about not just the game as such, but you start looking in a longer run, like the tournament eppadi win pandrathu, or how you can use a player, or which player will be used at their optimum level, and which player at that point will be able to. If, imagine if the wickets are falling really quickly, you really can't just think about yourself where you just how to handle it in your sake of the weather. You think about which player will be suitable at that point who can come in and steady the whole situation. So you have to start thinking for the 11 other players who are playing in the team.
Okay. Were you scared about losing like friendship with the other players? Like, if I have to make a certain decision that might not be, very well accepted.
I have, in fact. No, I have actually lost a lot of. Yeah, I have actually lost a lot of people in my life because of the brutal decisions that I have to take. But one thing I've always believed in is. Some things, that when you have to, when you have to always stand by things that you really believe in. So I believed in like giving the right opportunity for the right player, and eventually it all should boil down to winning the game or winning the tournament.
Winning the game.
So yeah, so that way I can happily say that though I've lost a lot of people, I've always stayed true to the game and to myself. So yeah.
Lovely.
So, have you ever taken such brutal decisions in your life where you had to miss people out on the mari?
Illa. Mine is very, very independent of my career and my life. Yeah, there are sometimes when you have to say no to a certain script because it doesn't vibe with your personality, or you think, okay, if people see me in this light, they might not like me that much. So that fear is there. You want to keep a certain image, even though if you want to experiment with certain roles, you can't do that all the time. Because ultimately, audience is king. Audience is the ultimate for us. Like, avangala eppadi nama vandu entertain panikalam. Okay, we do certain things for our soul satisfaction also. But why am I in the entertainment business? Because I want like those millions of people to accept the character that I play, and that compromise is always there. But we have to try and draw that line between what we like and what they like, always putting kind of their interests ahead. Adhu mattum I've always thought that you can never disappoint them, because avanga illana na who am I going to ask in front of the mirror? I can do whatever I want. But at the end of the day, when the producer is trying to invest money into the business, you have to keep like everybody happy. You have to do certain things that you might not like in a solo player, which might not vibe with your personality. So you if I do it completely for my happiness, I'll do one movie for I have to entertain my audience. What new can I do? What more can I do? And the madhya. are. So that's always like a very difficult task.
Did you always wanted to start acting from a very young age? Like, I can say na, I started playing at a very young age. Did you always wanted to become an actor from a very young age, or did you have a different aspiration?
No, actually, Tirush, I was like a joker in my family. If anybody wanted me to act, chuma, there'll be like some get-togethers and all. Angiyum, I would say, if anybody wanted me to dance,
dance adi kaatenga nu sonnaangala.
ஒரு பாட்டு பாடேன் and even in college I was part of the theater group, and I think it's always you kind of attract what you're always visualizing, and when you're watching movies, for me it was not like, hey, you know, that hero is so cute, you know, that heroine acted well. It was like, I wish I get to act with her someday, and what would it actually mean to, you know, be standing next to that actor and, you know, performing with him. So that kind of, I think, got me where I am today. I didn't actively go look for it, but somehow in that whole in the way I kind of got merged into this in the acting field. I can't pick a moment like that day that changed my life. For me, chinna vayasulunde oru there was one.
It just went with the flow.
To become an actor. So that was there. So
Was your actually your favorite moment in Salvanina, like in your acting career? I can say, like, I've always dreamed to act with this person, and did on the dream come true moment ever?
Okay, I'm gonna ask you the same question, but for me, okay, this is like pure luck. Huge fan of Surya. Okay. Okay. The Madri one, I was like huge fan of Surya sir, and when I got a chance to audition for Yeah Marino, I couldn't believe my eyes. When I was talking to Murgadas sir, like even before asking what that role and all was, I was like, Surya sir could have seen Irkuma. He was like, first you have to and then Murugada sir is like, adala irukuma first un character enna you want to know or not, and I was like,
adhu enna ma irundhu photo,
but just thought there's a scene with him, I'd be very happy. Couldn't believe my eyes. When I was reading the scripts, there were all these scenes with sir, and there was this really long, like, 2-page dialogue. I don't know if you remember the movie now, last, like, towards the climax, I had like big dialogues with Surya sir, and that was like the best moment of my life, because for 5-6 years you've only been like admiring this actor, and suddenly you get to do this with him. I thought it was unreal in my life. Idala nadakka mudiyuma appadina, like, I was somewhere sitting in Bangalore doing my college and degree and all that, and suddenly I'm in front of the camera and being directed by one of the biggest directors in India. So Surya sir kuda on the scene, very 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 memorable scene, and I remember that scene happened at 5:00 in the evening, and I was practicing from 7 in the morning, because I wanted to get it right. The key dialogue, the 2-page dialogue, and I knew if I don't practice, I will look at sir and I will just go blank, and I just was rehearsing those lines, and I got it in like one take, and apparently Surya
one take leva.
அதுக்கப்புறம் ஒரு 2-3 டைம் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் மேபி லைக் சம் டெக்னிக்கலி ஆர் சம்திங், ஓவரால் நாட் மோர் தென் 3 டைம்ஸ். அண்ட் ஐ திங்க் ஓகே சூர்யா சார் சேட் யூ ஆர் டூயிங் வெல், டோன்ட் வரி, டோன்ட் பி நர்வஸ் அண்ட் ஆல், பிகாஸ் ஐ திங்க் ஹி ரியலைஸ் தி
அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்
யுவர் பேஸ்மென்ட் வீக் இன் தி மாரி லைக் லைக் சார் ஷிவரிங் வென் ஐ வாஸ் ஆக்டிங் வித் ஹிம். அண்ட்
தென் வாஸ் தட் தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சீன் யூ டிட் வித் ஹிம்?
நோ, ஐ ஹேட் அதர் சீன்ஸ், பட் அது டயலாக் இல்ல.
Okay, but did you like on the awestruck moment?
Sorry?
அந்த ஆஸ்ட்ரக் மூமெண்ட்ல வந்து இல்ல எல்லாரும் சொல்லுவாங்க நடிங்க நடிங்கன்னு சொல்லிட்டு சொல்லும் போது இல்ல யூல் பீ லைக் லுக்கிங் அட் ஹிம் அந்த மாதிரி தான் நடந்ததா
எக்ஸாக்ட்லி சம்திங் லைக் தட் டோட்லி ஹேப்பன் டு மீ பட் வெரி தட் இஸ் த மோஸ்ட் மெமரபிள் மூமெண்ட் ஆஃப் மை கரியர் பிகாஸ் இட் மை ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபிலிம் I got to act with the biggest director and one of the best actors we have in our industry. Yeah. So yeah. Tell me about
when you're destined to do something, la, it happens. The best moment in my career la vandu like playing obviously adu vandu irukume like the big games when you really thought pulled it from where like no player no opportunity to win pandra edathila irundhu you try winning the games indradhu vandu adu nadandirukku but off the field one of my most memorable moment vandu I really like Dhoni a lot okay so we had this 2000 yeah so enna chena 2011 la we were at the BCCI awards so I won the cricketer of the year in Radhanala vandu I had to I had gone won the award and I came back and we were sitting like enna chena I was sitting here he was sitting a little in front of me so mudinjitta peruga after the event got over it was like after the post award we had a dinner that was going so I was standing there and I'm having my dinner and like you won't believe suddenly in a sudden you see someone in a mode Dhoni is just walking up to me and he was like congratulations on the award I was like awestruck for a moment I had this poker face and I was like apprinte na paathite irundha then he was like then he again repeated himself he was like illa congratulations on the award then I was like then I got back to message like thank you very much abdin solit irukkum bodhu we spoke a lot about to my surprise he is the kind of a person who will help another cricketer like I really wanted to know that how he was able to play that innings the 2011 innings and rather vandu to pull that kind of an innings and have that kind of a responsibility to step up and play in rather even at this point la I've always been surprised eppadi ortharala vandu adu panna mudiyum nittu because if you've taken notice throughout the tournament no he's ensured that the other players he tried to bring the best of the other players you know to go walk out on the Vankhede yeah to walk out in the Vankhede stadium with the jam packed idana mode with so many people lord dream ala poet sorry
and yeah
and valaiyadradendra it was not a joke so and vagaila vanda even this moment la I really felt and so the awestruck of feel pandradendra that innings of his so adha pathi kekkumbodhu he is like he really spoke enna solradha romba beautiful avar sonnaru like for someone who is enna solradha who achieved so much in namodhu to be able to share that experience with a fellow cricketers is really beautiful and I've really adhukku munadi varaikume I've admired him as a cricketer but adukapra vandu I started admiring him even as a person
wow
so that is one of my most memorable moments but the other people la namakku pidikum like even that day I met so many other people I met Sachin and all of them the Kapil avanga ellarume vandha enna na namakku vandu we respect them as legend but namakku personally vandha sila pera pidikum la like andha vagaila vandha I always loved Dhoni after that innings of 2011 world cup kapra and innings la nam enak romba pidikum அப்ப அவர் வந்து இந்த மொமெண்ட் இருக்கும் போது திஸ் டெஃபினெட்லி டாப்ஸ் என்ன சொல்றது த மோஸ்ட் மெமரபிள்னு கேட்டனா வந்து திஸ் ஒன் வில் டாப் மை லிஸ்ட்
வாவ் வாவ் அமேசிங் அமேசிங் வாட் டிட் யூ ஃபீல் when you played the first ODI Dhirush when you were batting and what was running in your mind like when you just got on
actually what happened is when you always think about cricket no I mean the one game that really keeps you going and so the people the fans or the audience that is always drilled into our mind is india pakistan game nale vandu full kovathodeyo full a very thanama poi valaiyadradha nam mind la irukom la so I don't know if it was a good thing or a bad thing the first game that I made my debut was against pakistan so it was like I was going in and playing and we've always had this thing like to be hindi la correct solla they say the kunnas eduthittu poi velaiyadnu appdinbanga that is what they kept on telling so the first moment when I stepped onto the ground I was like I was getting this whole hang of this whole thing like okay I've actually started then solla I'm representing the country and I'm playing a match that too I was playing in a Gaddafi stadium anga that is the most popular stadium அந்த ஸ்டேடியம்க்குள்ள விளையாடுறோம், இங்கதான் வந்து என்ன சொல்றது, சச்சின் விளையாடி இருப்பாரு, அவங்க விளையாடிப்பாங்க, இவங்க விளையாடி இருப்பாங்கன்னு நம்ம ஃபீல் பண்றதுக்குள்ளேயே வந்து மேட்ச் இஸ் அகேன்ஸ்ட் பாகிஸ்தான். சோ தட் வேல வந்து என்ன ஆகுதுன்னா, ஆக்சுவலி நல்ல வேலை வந்து அவங்களுக்குலாம் புரிஞ்சது, லைக் ஆல் மை சீனியர்ஸ் தே அண்டர்ஸ்டுட், ஓகே திஸ் கேர்ள் இஸ் லைக் லாஸ்ட் ஃபார் அ பிட், வி நீட் டு வென் அ புல் அப் பிகாஸ் ஐ வாஸ் ரியலி நர்வஸ்
at that point because
on the realization varulla like when you wear your jersey and you know and especially that whole series as such it was very memorable because that was the first time in a solo you have a jersey and your name printed on it and you have your jersey number you know and you feel really proud at that moment like that whole it was not just my journey it was a lot of people had sacrificed for me at that point like I told you people have been very cynical about this whole me taking up the career in cricket and amode so this whole thing really epdi solradana like or proud feeling avida it is like a dream come true not only for me but for a lot of other people
correct
so on the vagela vande playing against pakistan really did make an impact for me and that was most toughest thing in na feel pannala
yeah
ange irundhu vande my journey really started well like at that time when I used to bat and I used to bowl so I really that adukapratil irundhu when they kept on drilling this in my mind saying that or Pakistan game nu solla solla enalla I think it brought out the best in me in that solano
wow and how do you cope with bad days when you have not performed your best and when let's say you guys have lost the game and all what actually goes on in
you all
talk about that evening once you finish the match
see what happens is that's when team sport really comes into play like like imagine we have 11 players playing there'll be a couple of players who will have a bad day like say imagine I have a bad day and a friend of mine also has a bad day that's when you have the 9 other players who will back you on that particular day like they really keep encouraging you they'll be like imagine see if I've dropped a catch on a particular day or when I'm batting I would have missed out on a couple of shots I mean I missed on a loose ball that's when you have a lot of people who take responsibility for you and step in for you and they'll be able to make up for you on that particular day so that is when I mean that is how the team sport really happens like you back one another on a bad days or bad situation bad moments like there was one instance where I was playing and anikena paatha enna solradhu when I was fielding on the particular day la ella ball was chasing me and anik ella ball yum enakena paatha anik correct it was not catch I dropped a catch also on that day so I really enna solradhu that moment enna aguna pakkathula irukravanga enna aguna they keep telling you like ella solradhu okay yeah you'll be fine and solittu they keep encouraging you that's the beauty of a team sport when you play an individual sport like when you say tennis and all that no good day or bad day it is all on you but that when it comes to a team sport you have other people who really support you
I think that's the beauty of a good sportsmanship right? when you're playing as a team you don't blame each other at the end of the game saying because of you
exactly
the mariyala irukadala
no that never happens I mean you really don't blame anyone that is one good thing that tennis is that the sport as such has taught you like over a period of time what happened is maybe when you were young this would have happened like we start blaming each other like when we were like about say 10 or 12 we start telling them because of you this happened because of the me this happened and irukumode but over the period of time you know that is what the sport teaches you as such like how to support one another and how to motivate one another this is the quality not just the captain that possess but every other person in the team will start understanding one another and they will start playing like see I might have some kind of a flaw while playing and someone has a different flaw I need to understand that person and eventually when you put everything together no you have to bring out the best so that we are able to win the game or the tournament so that is the whole thing
yeah oh lovely another so another thing I wanted to ask you how has the game changed like when you started playing cricket to the girls who are coming right now into the into this field do you see like it's become easier nowadays or how was it easier for you when you started off
No, the only thing I would say the difference really appreciate and pathena, I think the infrastructure in Lamoda now a lot of people are more welcome about women or girls picking up the sport and playing it more professionally. So you can find a lot of girls who can enroll themselves in a coaching camp nearby, not only in Chennai but even in the other parts of outskirts of Chennai or other parts of Tamil Nadu. You have people who can encourage you to take up the sport professionally. I think that is a huge difference that I see, because for anybody to pursue something that they believe in, you need somebody to I mean you need the right infrastructure. So which I think I lacked a few years back. I think with the evolution in cricket and as such, the people have really I mean not only the infrastructure but also the parents' mindset. There are a lot of parents even now, I mean even the selection and all, you see parents bringing their kids for the selections and sort of staying there and then taking them back in. That is the kind of support that the parents are also giving the kids.
Correct,
Like
correct.
very recently, a lot of girls have skipped their sort of they've given up on their education to play the sport full time. So that is the
Oh.
kind of impact that the game has on the on either on
Oh,
people right
lovely.
now.
Lovely, lovely. Very quickly, can you tell me if there are a lot of girls who are watching this who want to, kind of think about starting a career in cricket or want to tell somebody else, அவங்களுக்கு what is the steps through which you have to go to, like, first in upon the
I think first thing you one has to start playing the sport, because before you want to take up as a career, just enroll yourself in a camp nearby so that you learn your basics and then you develop yourself as a cricketer. அதுக்கப்புறம் அண்ட் யூ ஹாவ் டு சி வாட் ஏஜ் கேட்டகரி, பிகாஸ் தேர் ஆர் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கேட்டகரிஸ். யூ ஹாவ் தி அண்டர் 16, யூ ஹாவ் தி அண்டர் 19 அண்ட் அண்டர் 23 அண்ட் த சீனியர்ஸ். தீஸ் ஆர் த கேட்டகரிஸ் இன் விச் த டோர்னமெண்ட்ஸ் ஹேப்பன். ஸோ யூ ஹாவ் டு சி விச் ஏஜ் கேட்டகரி யூ பிலாங் டு. இஃப் யூ ஹாவ் அன் அண்டர் 16 அண்ட் அண்டர் 19, ஜென்ரலி யூ வில் ஹாவ் நியூஸ் பேப்பர்ல யூ வில் ஹாவ் திஸ் ஆர்டிகல் விச் சேஸ் தட் தேர்ஸ் அ செலெக்ஷன் ட்ரையல்ஸ் தட் வில் ஹேப்பன். So you'll have to follow that, and you can also log into your TNCA. If I belong to the TNCA in Badanala, so you have to log into the website to see when is the trial happening, and then you come on that respective date, enroll yourself, and then you have your selection, and then after which you can take things forward. I mean, you get selected, you'll obviously be called in for a camp, and then you get to play your state games if you get selected in the state team.
Okay.
So that is the
Okay.
process as such.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. I want like a quick peek of what happens in the green room when you finish the match or before you go into a match, when you huddle and when you talk. What is that one thing that you guys discuss, or is it like a secret that nobody should know, Anda Maria?
Now, one thing in Aguna, before we go into the game, it has always been like the captain just goes and has a look at the wicket, like how the wicket will play on that particular day. Imagine if it's a green top, or you will have a flat wicket, or in case if it's a turn or track, the captain just goes and has an idea, gives us an insight about how the wicket is. And when we huddle up just before the game, we decide what we want to do. Because, like I
Okay.
said, when we talk about a team sport in a mode, the decisions that we take has to be a combination and then sort of the accumulative decision. I mean, it should be taken like every individual or the opinion is always mattered. So they come give us an opinion, they will come and ask us whether you want to chase on that particular game or whether you want to set your target. We make decisions just before the toss. And that is what
Okay.
we talk as such in the huddle before the game. And probably after the toss, you've decided whether if you're batting first or if you're bowling first. The second thing that we do is we set a target for ourselves. Imagine if we plan on the strategies as such. If we are batting first, we'll have a target for ourselves. We set targets 15 overs or 30 overs. What is the target that we are having in mind based on the wicket? Apply we plan strategies, and post game it is always the post mortem that we do, like
Okay.
what went wrong or what went right, like the things that really needs to be highlighted. Like someone has done well, you really have to kind of we appreciate them for what has been done, or something has really gone wrong. We kind of, I mean, we don't really pinpoint as such, but we bring it to notice. Okay. Like this has happened, and let's not repeat it in the forthcoming games and in Solitaire. We really talked about that. So,
okay.
This is
okay.
What happens post and pre-game.
Oh, okay. Somebody has asked me, yeah. Do you like playing with the red ball or white ball?
I've always loved playing the red ball cricket because that is more challenging, if you see. But white ball vandu is something that will help you dominate as a batter, because the rules as such is like, yeah, the rules as such is basically it is more batsman friendly. Appinamodu the white ball, it is like really gives you an opportunity to dominate up front, even if before you go on to playing the sport. I mean, even if before you go to play the game, it gives you an added advantage, madri. With the white ball, but the red ball is very challenging. Like it is like the batsman also has an advantage and the bowler also has an advantage. So it's like really competitive, anger. So if I really love playing the test ball, I mean the red ball, because it's more competitive that way.
Lovely. And what is the way ahead once you retire from playing the big league cricket and all that? Adhukapram, how can women take this sport forward and, you know, keep it going?
Like, I think after cricket, I have one thing in my mind is like, if the game as such should reach even the someone who is from the remote area, I think the game should reach even them, because someone would want to take up the game, but they don't really know how to do it because they do not have that opportunity to know how to go about it. Like if you say, number one, when India one, we say gully cricket in Solitaire, but then in some of the remote areas, you find these girls, you know, in the vayalla valaiyadrathu, they play in the fields and all that, you know, they also have the dream of, you know, so they dream big, they also want to go play for the country as such, but they really don't know how to take it forward. So I want to really tap that talent and give them the right opportunity and the infrastructure or the guidance for them to live their dream. So after cricket, beautiful. This is what I really look at doing.
Amazing. Are you like, is it an initiative by a group of people, like a community that is trying to...
I'm trying to really sort this whole thing out, because it is not a very easy thing, because when you talk about it, you have to really also handle the thing that you have to take care of the education also. When you really want to pick up a kid from a rural area and then bring them over here in Amodi, you also have to ensure that they get the right education. So it is something that I've been working on, probably with days to come, because there is also a lot of things that also comes into, because when you talk about bringing a cricketer who's from the rural area, not only is the education, but you also have to take care of their skills, and then, you know, so fitness, diet, everything has to be monitored. So we really need to have the right infrastructure and the right either for that kid to really grow up as a cricketer.
Correct.
So
I think that is
something.
Tirush?
Yeah, it is definitely expensive, not only in terms of practicing your skill, but when you talk about your diet and all, the thing has completely changed. Like, we have a lot of restrictions. Like, we can't really, if I'm bringing a girl from there, you know, I have to ensure that she hits the right amount of nutrition level, because that's when she'll be able to recover and be able to give her best. So that is something that more than anything else, I mean, buying your kit, because a bat right now that will cost you about 35,000, a good bat that if you want to play. So your kit and then your diet, and then to get the right mentors for you, and you get the education system going for them. I think this all will cost you. But I'm really trying to work on everything as such.
Lovely.
So that
lovely.
The people get
but
the best, because
with a lot of international players, how different is their training from the kind of training that you've been?
The training, actually, to be very honest, the training in Patana, the way we train, and the difference between us and an Australian, or if you take a New Zealand player or South African, skill wise, we are far ahead. There's something that we always need to catch up is our fitness schedule or the fitness regime that we've followed over the years. So that is something I think we really need to work on. But when I went for to Australia for a couple of weeks to get that in the fitness, eppadi vandu work pandranga endradhukaga, I went to this place called Center of Excellence in Australia. for a couple of weeks just to train with them. That's when I really understood that the more they emphasize is more on their skill ku munadi, they emphasize a lot on their fitness regime. Like even in this school, there's this thing where like they have a lot of people take up the education ku badala, simultaneously they don't pick the sport which they want to pursue. They play all the sports. They play football, they play a bit of hockey, then they play a bit of cricket, they play basketball, they play a lot.
Can you see me?
Yeah, I can see you.
Okay, there's no power, but I have a couple of friends who are holding the lights for me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, so apdi namode, even now, you know, there are so many people, like there's this there's a cricketer called Ellis Perry. She had represented the country on two sports. Like she's played international football and she's played international cricket as well. Likewise, there's a player called Susie Bates who's played international. I mean, she's an Olympian based, like off season la vandu she plays basketball, and then on season she plays cricket. And there's another player called Sophie Devine who plays she's an Olympian as well. She's played for international hockey, and she plays international cricket as well. So that is the kind of culture that is built in the countries like Australia, England, and in New Zealand. So that is something, you know, sort of is something different, which I see is different from here to there, where we emphasize a lot on just one particular sport, where the other players, they look into a different aspect. Yeah, different aspect as sport as such. Number one thing, we're very specific. Like imagine if I want to take up cricket, and I just go for my cricket coaching. If I want to take my tennis coaching, I only play tennis.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. I really want to take part in whatever activities that you are going to plan further ahead. In trying to look for really potential.
Really, I'll be happy.
I'd like to join hands with you sometime and do this with you. I want to plan something with you. Seems like a very exciting thing to do.
Yeah.
Last but not the least, I want to tell something to all those young women out there who are really, really passionate about taking up a career in cricket or sports in general.
No, I've always believed in one thing is not only cricket or a sport or any field that one chooses, you know, there are going to be a lot of struggles that you'll have to encounter on a daily basis, or when you look at the larger picture also, there's going to be a lot of struggles. I think you have to choose your career based on what you're passionate about, because that's when you'll be able to be determined in whatever you do. So I think that implies everyone has to love whatever they're doing. That is when you'll be able to give the best in whatever you do. So, I think you have to choose your career based on your passion. That is the bottom line.
Yay! Lovely. Thanks, Tirosh. I think we can wrap this up now, and we can do another session for the topic and just talk just about that. So much that I wanted to ask you, but I think it's been almost like 1 hour.
Next time, I'm going to ask about you. You asked about me. Now I want to ask about you next time when we do a live.
Definitely. Let's do this sometime next week.
Sure.
And any other campaign that you're taking up to look for like new talent, passionate cricketers, women cricketers out there, please let me know, and I can, you know, also help spread the word and be a part of this.
And I really like that initiative that you had with the women cab drivers. You know, that is something I think it is that we owe it to the society as such, because something that not only our family, we talk about our family, or when we talk about well-wishers around us, I also believe in one thing, that someone really comes and helps you, like a stranger comes and helps you. You wouldn't even have known that person. The stranger really comes up to you and helps you or motivates you at that point. So I think it is important that we give back something to the society, and that is something you're doing. I mean, remember you had sent me that thing about the female cab drivers.
Yeah,
that is a great initiative.
just doing our bit for the society, whatever we can.
Yes.
Everybody should have it in the back of their mind.
Yeah.
That there is somebody who will need a helping hand. In whatever situation that you are, there is somebody who will need help more than you. So,
true.
Always be around for such people. But great talking to you, Tirush. And
thank you.
Amazing college moments also.
Amma.
I think we'll talk about all that in our next session. Are you in touch with any of our other friends?
I'm in touch with Tanuja. I mean, you know Tanuja, the brightest student in our class.
Yes, the most beautiful comedy.
Yeah, so I'm in touch with her. I mean, yeah, that is the only person who I remember and I'm in touch with, and then apart from you.
Lovely.
Yes, I'm in Chennai.
So, we will talk soon.
Light. How is the situation there?
It's actually quite eased out. Not too many cases here. Lockdown eased pandirukanga, but still get people to, you know, stay indoors and stay safe as much as we can. But I think this is the last lockdown kapro, we have to be really careful.
So, yeah, everybody needs to stay safe.
You're working out at home only, la?
Yes, I am. It's up until 31st of May. So, the situation is like that. I mean, even after that, I really don't know when the grounds will open. It'll be the last thing that'll be opening up. Thank you. Thank you, Danya. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for having me over. Thank you, Danya. Thank you very much. I mean, it was really nice. Thank you.
See you. Bye, Girish.